I got a problem with those that are against it because most of them are ignorant. Ignorant means they don't know. I can teach those. Stupidity is what I can't tolerate.
What if I told you I could save the world? What if I told you it's all natural? Mother is a magic spear that you incredible lie that I told you were all about. Hey, what if I told you I could save the world?
The tree of life, here to heal all nations. We don't call it pot, we don't call it weed, we don't call it marijuana. It's cannabis because it is a sacrament from God.
It has to be done sacred. And all this usage that's not sacred is actually hurting us, not just physically, but spiritually.
It's a gift from us. It's something that we can walk out and grow that known that He put it on here for us. Specifically, He thought of us when he put it here. That's one example right there that He does exist and He is real.
Anybody who uses cannabis ought to connect with Greenfaith Ministries and say, hey, I want to straighten up my sacrilegious use of this herb. Teach me how to use it with the blessing of God, and I will be a cannabis warrior.
I don't know. That's an interesting deal. I've had my pot smoking biker friends are a little bit taken aback by my.
You have pot smoking biker friends?
Oh, sure.
The first stop on our cannabis quest was the home of Reverend Patrick in Colorado Springs, and I was pretty surprised how pissed off he was when we got there.
Unlike most people in the DEA and all these government fucking alphabet soup cocksuckers, we still have religion of freedom, and we don't look at this as a drug. We don't treat it as a drug. It's a sacrament. It's part of our lifestyle. It's part of our daily living.
Does the government recognize that?
They have to. They already have. Look at your history. See, I'm amazed you're doing a cannabis movie. You're about to get me upset, man. But you're doing a cannabis movie and you ain't done your fucking research on the plant. And you're here, you're doing an interview on a cannabis sacrament church, and you don't know very much about the plant itself, bro. Come on, bro.
This is something that has thousands of years of use. I mean, people, whether it's in Jamaica or where have you, have been using marijuana ceremonially and for spiritual, communion for years. We have not seen a whole lot of positive progress in the courts on this. There has been some movement where certain courts have recognized peyote, and people that have been using peyote or ayahuasca, these various drugs. We haven't seen the same court decisions come out and say marijuana is in fact appropriate for spiritual use yet, but it makes sense. I mean, the history's there, and that's a big component that courts look at. People feel very strongly that in fact it's part of their religion, and that is actually a factor the courts look at too. This isn't just something they don't feel strongly about. This is a part of their lifestyle, and I think the courts will come around on that.
Cannabis has been here since the beginning. Don't let it be our end. Don't let prohibition be our end. Let me do that over again. Cannabis has been here since the very beginning. Don't let prohibition be our end.
What do you think that are you against marijuana being sold in these dispensaries?
I want to legalize it. I don't smoke, but I want to legalize it.
You do?
So if it's in the dispensaries, it would help people instead of having to go to faraway places.
Are you against basically the dispensaries or people using it as a religious sacrament, like some of the Greenfaith Ministries?
No.
Not at all?
Not at all.
We're not doing anything wrong. If they want to waste the resources to come fucking look at us, come on in. We follow the laws. That's why we live here, to live within the laws. We don't want to be lawbreakers. We want to use our sacrament. That's all we want. We want to use it in peace. We want to look out our window and see fuckers in riot gear kicking in our door because we're growing some harmless plants.
Yeah, you're not bothering anybody.
We try not to. Not unless they bother to fuck us, and then we bother it to fuck up. You know? We put the end to it. If they bother us, then we put the end to it. I mean, because we're not here to be bothered. We're not here to be violent. But violence is like a bicycle. When you quit it, you put it in the corner of the garage. But did you forget how to ride that bicycle? No. You just choose not to act out on it. You choose not to pull it out of the garage and ride it. You know, different than you know, people that bring you trouble. I don't want no trouble. I don't cause no trouble. I don't bring you no trouble. Don't bring none to me. Because I will fight you one of two ways. I will fight you with a legal battle that you will never be able to fight. Or I'll fight you physically, and repercussions be damned if that's the way we got to go. You know, but when Christ said turn the other cheek, he didn't say keep turning it. You know, I can only be hit twice before I'm going to snap back. Most people give you the first shot. You know how everybody goes, I'll let you hit me once, go ahead. No, Christ said go ahead. I got two cheeks, I'll turn the other cheek. But he didn't turn his ass around until you hit him there either, did he?
I'm a Buddhist at heart. Most people that know me would say I'm like a Buddhist Christian, almost. You know, I follow all faiths. I think all paths lead to divinity. It really is a matter of taking what resonates well within your soul. You know, there's a lot of hands in a lot of these texts, and the Buddha actually did say, "Don't listen to me. Don't listen to anybody. You ask yourself." I came to Green Faith Ministries more or less very soon after I moved to Colorado in 2010. We began a partnership with Panera Bread that allows us to get their overflow from their corporate office in Flagstaff. And then we distribute that between Larimer County and Weld County. Hundreds of families get help through this resource.
Yeah, buddy.
I really want to see them do more of this sort of outreach to people, because the cannabis community, unfortunately, if you've been slandered, you have to actually be the better man. You know, it's not up to them. It's not up to you to convince them to treat you like the better man. It's up to you to be the better man.
So we went up to meet with Scoot Crandall, who's the director of Team Fort Collins, and he's also the driving force behind the dispensary closings in Weld County.
My position, and I believe our position here at Team Fort Collins, I would say, is that we would hope that folks could live lives that are free from intoxicants. We would hope that folks could take on life on its own terms and not have to alter that experience, whether it's through alcohol or it's through other drugs.
Have you ever drank alcohol or used marijuana?
No, I mean, that's kind of the oxymoron. To say I've never drank alcohol, that's not true. I've had a beer or two in my life. But I've never smoked marijuana. I don't do drugs. I may look like it, and oftentimes I'm accused of being a burned-out hippie. I was raised in the generation. I grew up in the 60s. I'm nearly 60 years old. But I myself, no, I don't do drugs.
How can you not get if you haven't tried it?
Well, you know, how can I knock it? I haven't tried that. That's one of those funny arguments. You know, I've never lost a finger on a table saw, but I know that it would probably hurt. So.
Well, I mean, a couple things. I mean, one, when you have places like Fort Collins that ban dispensaries, it's not like patients leave that community. What happens is, you know, the caregiver model comes into effect, and then people are essentially growing residentially. So that's what, if Fort Collins prefers to have residential grows as opposed to monitored, you know, commercial grows, then that's their prerogative. But, you know, a lot of people aren't fans of having their next door neighbor grow 50 marijuana plants. But that's what you're asking for when you ban dispensaries.
Why do you think they shut down all the dispensaries? You know, are you guys from Fort Collins?
We are. We have no idea. You know, we voted it in once, and then they took off with it, then they voted it out. I don't understand why. It just keeps going back and forth.
Team Fort Collins spoke out around the dispensaries for years, and our primary concern from the very beginning of the discussion was we were having a decrease in the perception of harm around the drug. Amongst young people, were not perceiving this as a harmful substance, and we're having an increase in the availability of the drug. Two very common variables that lead to increased use. And we have said that all along, that this is not a good thing for our young people.
You know what? Have a conversation with your kids. Like, you know, your kid just doesn't get a dime bag from his friend one day. He's got to hang out with these kids a long time. Didn't you know who they were hanging out with the whole time? You ever met them before? Do you ever have them over the house? Do you ever meet their parents? Like, hello?
Glenn, I've smoked it since I was 6 years old.
So in Fort Collins, you know, we were at a place where we were trying to decide and continuing to decide our community identity. And what was happening in our town from our perspective and from others was that our community identity was shifting towards a lot of distribution of marijuana, a lot of use around marijuana. And the downside to that was that our young people were beginning to use marijuana at higher and higher rates, and that was disturbing to us.
Was the marijuana that the kids were using, was that stemming from the dispensaries? Or was it coming from other sources?
I think it was coming from other sources as well as dispensaries.
They can't get it at dispensaries. They don't get it from dispensaries. Dispensaries is not the problem. Prohibition is.
We had a number of reports from many families that would indicate that they actually found marijuana in their kid's room. It was in a dispensary container. A lot of young people would indicate to us that they were purchasing surplus marijuana from folks that were holding cards, that were not using all the marijuana that they were purchasing as a cardholder, and then reselling that. So in our opinion, we were seeing kind of a new black market emerge here in our community.
They're still going to be selling it. They're still going to be using it. Their power company is going to be fucking in for a big fucking jackpot because the people are going to be growing it in their homes. Unfortunately, when that occurs, you can't determine whether they're selling it to kids. You can't determine whether they're selling it to legitimate patients. You can't determine whether or not fucking Mexican Mafia is selling it in the black in the underground, in the black market. You can't determine shit if it's done underground. That's why we at Greenfaith, we do everything in the light. If you don't hide nothing, they can't get by with nothing.
Greenfaith Ministries is a registered nonprofit. However, they're unable to get a loan from any bank in order to purchase a property to worship, like this church here, all because of their affiliation with cannabis.
Are you a spiritual man yourself?
Oh yeah, I would consider myself a spiritual man.
A Christian Catholic?
Yeah, I'm a pretty solid follower of Jesus.
There's more evil in the church today than there is on the streets. You send your kid to a Catholic church, he's getting butt-fucked by a pope.
Do you think that other adults should have the freedom to practice their religion, even if it includes using marijuana?
You know, I guess the thing that I would want, just personally, is... and this is just a personal feeling, is a reassurance that this is an authentic use of that sacrament. Who am I to authenticate the use of that sacrament? But I would hope all people, whether it's a Catholic in the use of wine in their sacrament, or it's a native in the use of peyote in their sacrament, I would want that to be an authentic representation of some deeply held spiritual philosophical position, and not co-opt that in some sort of way to justify their own recreational behavior.
You know, Catholics drink, you know, wine at church. A lot of those same people are relaxing with it later that night. So it's sort of, you know, it's not without precedent that people would use, you know, a, quote, mind-altering substance in a number of different ways. And that doesn't mean that because they use it recreational or medically, that doesn't, in fact, make their spiritual use still meaningful to them.
Is there a difference between the religious use of marijuana and using marijuana religiously?
Very good question. Nice. Yes, there is. Using marijuana for religious purposes is cannabis, man. Rewrite that shit. It's cannabis. Okay? Using cannabis for sacramental purposes is altogether different than smoking it like I do. I do it for the sacrament, but I also do it for my medicine. But smoking it religiously is just being a stoner.
Some people have a difficult time understanding the concept that the religious use and medicinal use of marijuana go hand in hand. I mean, it's basically the same thing, and even the Native Americans who use peyote as a sacrament refer to that sacrament as medicine.
Cannabis, and I've been, it's funny because normally you can't get me for 2 seconds without saying cannabis and how it relates to everything. It does. It really does relate to everything. And my wife today, cannabis doesn't cure everything, Bill. I'm like eating breakfast, you know, like it's just so funny because I'm not everything, but it, you know. And we remember the Chris Rock skit where he's like, "You should put some Tussin on it." You ever see the Tussin skit? Just rub some Tussin on.
As all we had when I was a kid, Robitussin. No matter what you got, Robitussin better handle it.
Hello, there ain't no pharmaceutical gonna claim they cure cancer or cure diseases, do they? No, they don't cure diseases. They treat your symptoms so you're still gonna die. This plant saves your life. You know, I can't make this into a pill form because they've already tried. Marinol. Yeah, ask anybody that takes it. It's bullshit garbage. You know? Pharmaceutical is a version of profiteering on God's design. There we go back to the word. All these things that are designed that they tell us are so good for us. We'll look into what the Bible says in Isaiah 5:20. It says, "Woe unto them that turn bitter into sweet, and sweet into bitter, and darkness into light, and light into darkness, and good into evil, and evil into good." And then I got a new saying, fellas. Let's change it from being a stoner. Let's say we're treed instead of being stoned.
Streed?
We're treed.
Treed.
Treed. It's a tree, right? Yeah. It's plant.
Smoking trees.
We're treed. Stoning means you're getting hurt, ain't it? Throwing fucking rocks at each other? That's cocaine, man. Just my new saying. Instead of saying I'm stoned, I say I get treed.
Yeah, it's kind of like, I guess if you're using mushrooms, you're shrooming.
Hello, you fucking nailed it. How hard is it? Why are we still called stoners? Call me a tree hugger. I love it. I'm a tree hugger, for God's sake. I'm not a stoner. I don't throw rocks at people, you know?
You don't think it's making people more violent in the town or causing crime?
No.
Probably less.
Do you believe that marijuana makes people violent and causes violence in the community?
I don't know about violence. I do know that I've received from marijuana advocates since the vote in November here in Fort Collins, I've received numerous death threats. Now, that's pretty violent. They've been ranging from simply kicking my ass to wishing I was dead and found under a rock.
The following are your saved messages.
Hi, I would just like to know how you sleep at night taking away medicine from patients, you fucking piece of shit, pig, motherfucker. How do you think deregulating the market's gonna make it safer for kids? You're fucking stupid.
Hey, dipshit, just saw your show there. I hope you get a debilitating disease that makes you not have so much pain that you don't know what else to do, and someone like you decides that you can't have any relief. So I just want to say, good suck a bag of dicks, you fucking asshole, and fuck you and the horse you rode in on, you shithead. Fuck you.
We've heard the arguments from the key debaters, but we wanted to hear from the general public, so we hit the not-so-mean streets of Fort Collins.
Hey, you guys want to comment on weed, pot, marijuana? Excuse me, sir. Can I talk to you about weed, pot, marijuana? Hey, guys, I'm doing a documentary about marijuana. About cool. The cannabis churches. You guys don't want
to... Nah, I'm good.
Sure?
Yep.
Come on, man. You want to talk about weed?
No, thank you.
Marijuana, you for or against it?
Never tried it.
Excuse me, are you for marijuana? Yo, man, you smoke weed?
No.
Hey, are you guys for or against marijuana?
For it! We are for it! For it!
Right on!
Thank you!
Hey, sir, I was wondering if I could talk to you about, what's going on with the marijuana movement here in Fort Collins?
I'm not from here.
You're not from around here? Where are you from?
Wyoming.
Wyoming. You're just down visiting. That's cool. Are you against marijuana in general? People using it as either a religious sacrament or for medicinal uses?
It's hard to say. I'm a Vietnam veteran.
Did you smoke any in Vietnam? Are any of your friends?
I don't know any about that.
Okay.
You have a beautiful one.
All right. Be good.
I have to say one thing. If you smoke pot and you drive a car, and then you should be held accountable if you caused a wreck. Somehow there needs to be certain limits when you can smoke pot. Let's say if you fly an airplane or a train. Now, I don't think that's a good idea, but you should be able to smoke pot walking around here.
Hey.
Are you for the marijuana movement?
What's that movement?
What do you guys think about all the dispensaries being shut down here? You think it's just a pain in the ass for all the people who need to...
I don't give a shit. I can get it regardless.
You got a guy? I guess everybody's got a guy, right?
Yeah.
Are you for or against it?
For it.
For it? Do you smoke it?
Nope.
Well, you don't mind other people that do?
Nope.
Hey, man. Yeah, you wanna...
Am I interrupting something?
Nah, not at all.
No. What's going on?
Do you wanna talk? I'm doing a documentary about...
Oh, God.
Marijuana.
About marijuana?
Yeah, yeah. Are they really hurting anybody by...
No, hell no. When have you ever heard of a stoner getting so pissed off that he goes and breaks into a window or robs somebody or something?
They're pretty mellow.
Yeah, pretty mellow.
And, So you're
high
all for...
as fuck right now.
You're for...
You cannot argue with the truth. Okay, I can tolerate ignorance, but once they know the truth, then that's stupidity, and I can't argue with stupidity because that's below me. And our goal in all of this is to let society know that we're just like you. We work every day. We don't sit at home in our mother's basement playing fucking video games that the stereotype has put us.
You're so
good. God damn! Fuck! I don't know a pot smoker that fucking can't, that don't work, because they can. Because ain't nobody just gonna get them high all the time for free. Shit costs money.
This is an unstoppable wave. You know, we're at this tipping point where the more the American public gets used to medical marijuana, learns that it's not this demon weed that kills people or is a gateway or whatnot, the more they learn about the fact that we can tax this and regulate it and keep it away from kids, the more they're going to vote our way. So I think, you know, this is really a movement that's unstoppable, and within a couple years we'll have a state or two that fully have a method of legalization, and that'll just be a model for the rest of the country.
One message, one voice, one goal. Because right now we're sounding like 1,000 fucking birds chirping and we just walk by and don't even really hear them. But if they all started singing in fucking harmony, people stop and go, wow, ain't that a pretty sound? You've done it. You walk by a bunch of crows, rah, 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 different sound, you don't hear them. But when you hear them pretty songbirds singing, you stop and listen, don't you? Because that's one voice. You might have multiple birds, but they're making one song. That's what we need in this country. One voice, one message, one fucking goal. Re-legalize cannabis and hemp to save our fucking nation. This is the land of the free, home of the fucking brave. My question is, where's the fucking brave?
Sweet Jesus.
I say Jesus.
Jesus.
Christ.
See, I don't believe this 2012 crap that we're going to end. I believe we're going to shift into another form of enlightenment to where we're going to refuse to be force-fed bullshit. Should be a Washington lobby and keep their ass in Washington and lock on them a fucking legislature's door every fucking day. Be in their face so they're so tired of them, they're just gonna listen. Just fuck it. Just tell me what you gotta tell me. But no, they'd rather be off writing books and spouting off that the medical marijuana industry is a farce. Who in the fuck are you? Don't make no fucking sense to me, but hey, who says any of them crock-eyed motherfuckers make any sense?
Jesus, take up your robe. Oh, Jesus, keep your sins away. Jesus, wearing them shoes and fucking bloody shoes, hanging up on the cross like a fool.
They can pass any law they want, but it only becomes a law if we accept it. They can write anything they want on pieces of paper.
Christ. Pretty God, we love you.
Let my people go.